Some Muslim men practice this ayah or this habit of hitting their wives, saying that this is what Quran says, this is what Hadith says, that hitting wives is allowed if they don't listen to you. This is a wife abuse. My dear brothers and sisters, this kind of practice has been prevalent and frequent in our society. A lot of women get hurt, a lot of families are destroyed, and in the process, the whole community suffers, the whole community becomes weak. And in the long run, the whole social life becomes destroyed. We should analyze and we should realize the relation of marriage, the relation between husband and wife, that husband and wife's relation is not based on hatred, exploitation, jealousy, or abuse. Rather, it is based on love, affection, compassion, love, and mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Quran, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. And among his signs is that he created for you mates from among yourselves so that you may find repose in them. And he has put love and affection between your hearts. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says in a sahih hadith, وَصِيكُمْ بِالنِّسَاءِ خَيْرًا خَيْرُكُمْ وَخِيَارُكُمْ خِيَارُكُمْ لِنِسَاءِ. I recommend that you treat women in goodness, and the best among you is the one who treats good with his women. My dear brothers and sisters, though Islam promises protection to women, but the ground reality in some families is totally different. People resort to violence, hitting and abusing their wives. And in many families, women suffer, and they suffer from different types of abuse. And the most common form of abuse is the emotional and mental abuse. And this includes the verbal threats of giving divorce, remarrying, or taking the kids away if she does not do exactly as she is told to do. Like threats to ridicule, degradation, insults, name-callings, criticism. Likewise, false accusations, blaming her for everything, telling her she is a failure and then she will go to Jahannam, to hell, twisting Islamic teachings in order to make her feel miserable, worthless because she is a woman, restricting her access to transportation, medical care, food, friends, money, social service, isolating her socially and physically, breaking promise, lying, and destroying trust. All this kind of stuff come under the category of mental and emotional abuse. And although this is contrary to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, unfortunately, it's an irony that Muslim men do not give any importance to this kind of abuse, saying that, rationalizing their action, that this is not serious unless he hits her, he beats her. Then it becomes serious in their opinion. My dear brothers and sisters, psychologically, mental abuse is more severe to some of the women, to the point that some women have mental breakdown and they go insane. It makes them question their self-worth. It destroys their self-esteem. And this psychological, this mental, and this emotional abuse leads to practicing physical abuse. And the physical abuse includes pushing, choking, punching, hitting, beating, assault with a weapon, tying her up, and throwing physically out of the house. All these things include under the physical abuse. And this physical abuse is more prevalent in the society, it's more severe. And similarly, some of the women suffer from sexual abuse. Like Mufti Saiful Islam says, okay, enjoy this physical relationship, enjoy your married life, but there are some restrictions. Sexual abuse includes violent and forced sex. For example, a wife is going through hard times. If she has some medical problems, she may not want to have this intimate relationship in the bed with the husband, while the husband is forcing her to have it. And in this also include the ways which are non-Islamic, which are not allowed. And a husband wants to get his satisfaction through the means, through the sources, or through the ways which are not allowed in Islam, through the wife, and wife is not allowing him. Because she's a Muslima, she understands it's not allowed in Islam, and the husband, in order to get his carnal desires satisfied, does the thing forcefully. This is a sexual harassment, this is a abuse for the woman. And it's an irony, it's very unfortunate that some men, some Muslim men have made Islam to justify their abusive behavior, focusing on rituals, considering themselves Islamically knowledgeable, disregarding the very spirit of Islam. They demand full obedience from their wives. They go on the power trip for the women, following an ayah, and they wrongly misunderstand it, they wrongly present it to the world, which in there is an ayah, أَرِجَالُ قَوَّامُونَ عَلَى النِّسَاءِ, that the men are the protectors and the maintainers of the women. And in the process, they say that they have full control over the women, and they need full obedience from them. Whatever they say, they have to follow. And they roam around giving the orders, and they expect wife to just follow the orders, say nothing. And if the wives stand up, if they speak up, if they put questions about their orders, they misinterpret yet another ayah of Quran, saying how to treat to a wife who is disobedient, and using it as a license for the abuse. وَالَّتِي تَخَافُونَ نُشُوزَهُنَّ فَعِذُوهُنَّ وَهَجِرُوهُنَّ فِي الْمَضَاجِعِ. My dear brothers and sisters, I was discussing in the beginning that Quran and Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam provide clear instructions on how a husband use the procedure in a conflict situations where the husband is innocent, he is compassionate, he is well behaved, while the real cause of the problem comes from the wife. In that case, Quran lays down all these procession, all these procedures to be followed. First, sit together, hold discussions about the problems and the solutions. And this is intended to soften the hearts of each other and to eliminate any kind of misunderstanding whatsoever in the marriage. And if it does not work out, then the second option should be followed. The husband should be very much strict. He should be expressive in a decisive manner about his expectation. He should tell his wife. If still rebellion or disobedience is still there, then he should isolate her in the bed, not in the house. He should not leave the house. He should be there in the house, but not in the same bed. And actually, this